दादाजी टू. आई हैड कन्वीनियंटली रिमूव्ड ऑल दैट एंगल, जस्ट केप्ट इट फॉर पुटिंग आउट वेरा पोसा, नॉट कमेंटिंग, गिविंग ओपिनियन, नथिंग. अच्छा thank you for joining us on a brand new episode of 420 grams as we are in day 2 of our euro coverage, and we'll be talking about the games that transpired last night. That is day 2 of the European Championships 2021. Three games in total. The first game was played between Wales and Wales and Switzerland. The second game was Denmark-Finland, and the third game was Belgium beating Russia by a 3-0 margin. But if any of you watched the games yesterday, all of you would know that irrespective of whatever the results were in either of these games, the results didn't really matter, because it was that kind of a day. It was that kind of a day where someone's life was on the line, if I may say. I'm talking about the Denmark and Finland game, where at the end of the first half, Danish midfielder Christian Eriksen collapsed unopposed. It's key to know that he had collapsed unopposed, and that's the scary part. As soon as he collapsed on the field, medics were called, the game was stopped, and the Danish medical team head also came on after the game. He came on and said that when they went there, Christian's pulse was there. He was fine. He was being kept up in a position by his captain, Simon Kjær, so as the proper airflow is continuing, and his head was vertical. And after that, in between, his pulse went. By that time, the medical teams had come, and then they tried to, of course, resuscitate him and bring him back to life. And play was halted for close to 20 minutes. 20 minutes play was halted. In between that, the Danish players had formed a circle around Christian and the medical team so as to, respect the privacy of the moment. After about 10 minutes of this incident playing out, the Finnish team was sent back into the ground, into the tunnel. And thereafter, about 10 minutes after, Christian was taken in a stretcher back into the inside the stadium. And play was suspended for close to 2 hours. And then came the good news. The good news being from Christian's father, who had spoken to Christian Eriksen's agent, who put out the news that everyone was waiting for, is that he is stable, he is breathing fine, and he is now being looked after by proper, he's been given proper medical care in a hospital nearby, the stadium in Copenhagen. So the result at the end of the day of what really transpired is a scary, scary evening. Whether you're sitting in India, whether you're sitting in any part of the world watching it on television, it's difficult to watch all of this, and it's difficult to talk about all of this. But at the end of the day, Christian is fine. So that is a good thing. But it's not the first time that something like this has happened. If you jog your memory back to November 2004, jog your memory back to a Federation Cup final between Mohun Bagan and Tempo, the result at the end wasn't what transpired last evening. And that day, it was a young Brazilian footballer who played for Tempo Sports Club who lost his life. And two people who know this incident really well, we have Jaideep Basu with us, who was in the ground at that time in November in 2004, covering the game as a journalist. And also Ishfaq Ahmed, who was a member of that Tempo Sports Club team that lost one of their, he was a solid striker. He was so good at what he did. He was part of that team with Tempo Sports Club. My name is Arjun. I'm also joined by Siddhant Annie today on the show. Gentlemen, today we're not going to be talking about Christian, because that's already played out and now we're waiting for a diagnosis as to what happened. But we'll also talk about, this incident. And since we have two of you, Jaideep and Ishfaq, Jaideep, I'll start with you. If you could narrate us what happened that day. It was the Kantirva in Bangalore, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
How it panned out after that.
See, in that year's Federation Cup, one thing was very clear, that Cristiano Junior was hogged the limelight, because previous year he played for East Bengal and played very well, and he was taken by Dempo. And actually, what happened 2 years prior to that, I think 2 years back or 1 year back in Chennai, Mohun Bagan beat Dempo in the final in the Federation Cup, and that was on the strength of two foreigners, that is Barreto and Seriki. They scored goals and Tempo lost against Mohun Bagan. And this year, that year that we are talking about, 2004, everybody knew that Tempo was going to win because of Christian. Christian is in very good form. So day before the final, they were in a hotel, I remember, just behind the gate road, a very tall hotel, quite I think 8-10 floor hotel. So we not only me, a lot of journalists went to meet him. So he talked to us. Later on, we came to know he was not well at that point of time, but which we cannot confirm. So what happened on that day, Dempo was the better team and Dempo was leading by a goal. In the 78th minute of the match, I remember it very distinctly because I noted it down. 78th minute of the match, Mohun Bagan, of course, was going on a going all out for an equalizer. And on a counter-attack, Dempo came back and there was a position when the ball came, when Cristiano and Subroto Paul, Mohun Bagan goalkeeper, were alone on the box. And Subroto came charging, and it looked he has collided with Cristiano. To some people at that time, it looked he hit Cristiano on the face. But Cristiano, what he did, he managed to get the goal. It was 2-0. It was his second goal of the match. Actually, he died scoring a goal. He was a striker and he died scoring a goal. And he fell down on the ground. I still remember, I noted it down, 78th minute, Dempo second goal. And as I looked onto the ground, I found he was still lying there. Mm. He was not moving. Nobody expected that he will die on the ground. So everybody thought some problem. So after around 10 minutes or 7-8 minutes or so, the ambulance came. Mm. He was put on an ambulance. He was taken away, and the match restarted. Which Balu was the referee. Later on, he was accused of starting the match again. But the thing is that it was the decision of the organizers, Karnataka State Football Association, to start the match. They started the match. Match finished. Even the prize distribution were met. Dempo were champions. They were given the cup and all these things. And still, we are waiting to know what has happened to this boy. That time, Marcos, who is currently in Times of India, he was in Goa. Goa Herald at that time.
So Marcos, Herald or Naveen?
Huh?
I thought Naveen Times.
No, he was in Goa Herald.
Okay. At that
time. So Marcos called me up. He said, "Sir, any idea about Cristiano?" I said, "No." He said, "My information says he's dead." So I was absolutely shocked. I said, how can it be? So I called up Mr. Colasso, Alberto Colasso, the general secretary. He was in the hospital. Actually, he said, in a minute, I was about to call you, Jaideep. Just come on. He is dead. So it started. Then I told the others also. So I took an auto, went to the hospital. And what I remember the most at that time, inside the hospital, before I could see the boy lying on the table or whatever, I could see the Ranty Martins crying loudly, so loudly that everybody in the hospital could hear, and he was almost falling on the chest of Cristiano and crying loudly, and Armando was standing there. So I just touched Armando. Armando looked at me and started crying. So it was, see, in my so many years of experience as a football reporter, I have never experienced such a thing in my life. And it started, then he was taken to the morgue. We went there in the night in the morgue. Next day he was cremated in Bangalore only, I remember. So we were all there. So it on and on. There was some inquiry whether Mishtu was responsible for hitting Christian or not. Then
Mishtu being Subroto Paul.
Found out no, Subroto was not responsible. So many things. Subroto almost had lost his career. He was the most hated man. Next year when he went to Goa, he was stones were thrown at him. He was booed by the spectators. Everything, all these things happened.
But and he was, I think, in the 1920 at the time, right? He was very young himself.
And he was very aggressive. Everybody knows he had always been a very aggressive player. There's no doubt about it. Even now, today, he's very aggressive. But of course, he was not responsible for his death. No way. But there was a theory at that time. Nah? There was a theory, even AFF appointed a committee to look into it. What I would like to add here that AFF appointed a committee to look into it. Then Mr. Dash Munshi held a press conference at his residence in front of Khan Market, I still remember, in which he said a lot of things which really, I don't know. He meant nothing, actually, like a politician. But nobody appointed a committee to look into the affairs of the Karnataka State Football Association. That why the match was stopped, why the ambulance was late, why the prize distribution were held when they perfectly knew that this boy's on the deathbed. Nobody had inquiry committee or anything. So it slowly died down. Of course, Subrata also came back to the ground here. Matlab, everybody forgot, but the boy never came back. That's all I can say.
Ishfaq, just hearing, sir, I'll be honest, and he's narrating a tale of that's happened in 2004. Maybe thoda hilam, and I'm guessing anyone who's hearing, and it stays with you. You were not there on the ground at that day because you were nursing an injury.
You were part
of the team. What was the impact on the team? The immediate impact on the team, because these are boys, and he's a player you shared dressing room with him.
Well, honestly, when Junior was signed for our team, we knew that we need a striker like him, and we will have a very strong team with him. And I still remember Coach Arman saying that we have a very good team and we should win this cup before going prior to Federation Cup. He had felt home when he came to Goa. He was treated well, everything. He was enjoying it there. His football, as Dada already said, both the goals were scored by him. He was a fabulous player. Very, very fast, good in air, can score with the both feet. And he was very good human being, very nice human being also. I remember I was in touch with Stanley Klosso that same day after the match. They were all in hospital, as Dada already said. And he quietly told me, I think he's no more. And then I spoke to coach and he said only, Ishfaq, I can't believe, and he started crying. And it was I was emotional. I was kind of literally crying as well. And because he was one of your teammates.
Yeah.
And knowing he was a fabulous human being, very down to earth, he never had any kind of attitude. And but one of the person who was hardest hit was Armando from entire team. I still remember, for him it was really hard because he was the one who convinced him to come because he had a fantastic season with East Bengal, and he was the one who convinced him to come to Dempo. Was pretty close with him. So I still remember they used to have a junior day in Dempo, kind of sad day for entire Dempo company. Even Mr. Srinivas Dempo used to come that day. It was a very, very sad day, but honestly, we never had any idea before people can die in football. For me, this was a shock. We were kind of backward in those days in football. Ek ambulance mangaya bahar wo sadak pe kya kehte hain wo lifestyle jahan pe hai Kanterwal stadium mein wahan pe bhi khadi rahegi to koi problem thi. So most of the matches we used to play. Even those days in Calcutta also, there used to be no ambulance. I think later on, AFF and with the you know, like awareness and everything, it became compulsory. I still remember when I was in Mohun Bagan, we won a match against Dempo, I think 2007. 2007 we won a match, and it was against Dempo. We beat them. Habibul after the match, Habibul Rahman Mandal, he collapsed. And I remember, you know, like what had happened in my former team. I was again shocked. He couldn't move. And it was again, you know, like touch and go kind of case, because his entire body had cramped. And I think they had to call ambulance later on. And to take him to the hospital, and due to same condition, it was not a heart condition, but it was a different condition due to which later on he had to quit mainstream football.
Ishwar, just one final point. You spoke about 2007. I'm sticking to 2004. That when you go back to the field as a team, how difficult was it to get back onto the field? And start,
I can tell you, it was very, very difficult. It was very, very difficult. And even, you know, I told you the coach was devastated. He was in no mood to continue. He was, you know, like inside, it was killing him that, you know, like we couldn't do anything for him. You know, there was sense of that thing in had everything been on right time, medical team would have been there, maybe, you know, like sahi time pe agar matlab unhone sahi kaam kiya hota to shayad bachne ke chances the, but you know, like that was devastating for him. He felt that we couldn't do anything, because, you know, like as a coach, what can you do? We as a player can't do anything. You know, like we are not trained for those things. But today I feel emergency situation, medical situations, entire team and staff should be educated. And it was really hard for coach. And I used to see him. I could see he's not mentally, you know, ready to take classes. And it remained with him for a long time. I still remember for a long time.
Yeah.
There was a very much sense that it happened with Subrata Paul. He was one of the hated guys, as I said. But I still remember a decision taken by Dempo Club and Armando that time, that he came openly. He said it could have happened with anyone. Subrata had never an intention to do that, and that was good from, you know, like the
big thing, big thing to say. Big thing to say. So big thing to say. Just very quickly, you know, you were talking about Armando. I remember a few years later, I was working for Z, who were the host broadcasters at that time, and a similar incident happened versus Churchill Brothers in a Federation Cup game in Calcutta. It was Ranti and I think Okba Kalu, both clashed and were taken to the hospital.
Baba Lade.
I remember post-match interview, Armando was, you know, he was not shaking. You could make out his mind was not there. You were playing that match. So his mind wasn't there at all. So, you know, you kind of get a sense. You say you don't probe him any further. You just quickly finish the interview, ask about the players and move on. Anibhai, just tells you the importance of medics, right? Split-second decisions. Simon Kaya coming in, he's done that because he has some knowledge.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right? Then the team doctor comes.
Yeah.
He's checking pulse. Then the pulse goes and the medical team is there. And then they resuscitate him and take him out.
Yeah. No, what Ishwar was saying is spot on. In that, like, so much awareness and so many protocols are now in place. Starting from the top, where the policy comes down that you cannot have a match unless there are paramedics, there's an ambulance that is on call available right there at the ground. you see now in Kantirva and stuff, the ambulance is actually parked almost on the pitch, you know, or at stadiums like Kalyani and stuff where it's just off the pitch. So that's made a huge difference. The awareness that players have, the training that they receive on a day-to-day basis, that's also made a huge difference. And like we saw yesterday, I mean, the awareness of the people in the immediate environment as soon as it happened, that made a huge difference and probably played a big part that immediate, you know, in that critical juncture.
The pressure bubble you're working in at that
but,
time.
Yeah. I also just want to quickly bring up how, you know, because we were talking, Jaideep was mentioning how when the Cristiano incident happened back in 2004, there was an investigation into perhaps what happened on the pitch, but there was no investigation into the functioning of the organization or the, those who are responsible for holding the match and why care was not given. Yesterday was, in a sense, the exact opposite because we are having this tournament, the entire tournament is taking place in the situation of a medical emergency globally, right? So a lot of conversation and attention has been paid to the kind of medical setup that comes with it to support these players and the bubbles they are in and to limit it from the infection point of view. But this is, of course, a different kind of, you know, whatever happened to Christian Eriksen. But the response of it, the response time and the testing of the systems that are in place, I think UEFA will be quite pleased with the work that they managed to do, as well as the host nation, the venue, the local organizing committee, I think will be very, very relieved and pleased that they managed to bring this boy back from the brink.
So very quickly, you know, hum to yahan baat kar rahe hain, ye highest level hai, to highest amount of budget hai. So, you know, you can procure all these things and you can set such standards. India mein bhi agar aap dekho, Karnataka mein ek local league mein, I remember a boy succumbed to a heart attack. Yes, MDFA elite division mein bhi hua hai. Aisa hua hai scene. And agar aap America mein dekho.
In Kashmir last season, one boy died in, I think, was it in Budgam or Sopor? Probably.
Baramulla district it was, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, in America, lower leagues also, there's a full study done on it. That there are a lot of, you know, players who've collapsed like this on the field. But it's just that you don't have the proper medical attention. Have we come, you know, so generally, sir, kya kehte hain ki 2004 mein jo ghatna ghati at the highest level in India, you tend to learn from it. And can we say we've learned from it? Because the same thing happened in the ISL final. Amir Ranaude, he collapsed. Medical help came. And we don't know the science behind it, how you do it, what you do. But the good news is the boy survived. And he's hale and hearty right now.
Yeah, Arjun, I think, awareness has come. But for that, if you ask me, Cristiano Jr. had to lay down his life. I will go back to an incident in 1988-89 Santosh Trophy when Bengal footballer Sanjeev Datta, who was popularly known as Raja. Raja, you remember, died on the ground. And he died without any medical attention. I can say it with conviction that he was a victim of All India Football Federation's poor policy. There was no medical attention. He was taken to the hospital by the time he had died. But for 15 years, nobody learned from it. Cristiano Jr., if in 2004 had to die almost in the similar condition, nothing changed in 15 years. The poor boy came all the way from Brazil to earn a few dollars in India and had to lay down his life here just because he knew how to play football and knew better than a lot of Indians, to be very frank. So, uske baad jo hua, 2004 ke baad bhi, I won't say a lot of things have changed. But I would say, in the second decade of the this century, things have changed. Now the policy has come that if you see in the lot of teams in the nursery league complain that we have to put a ambulance and all, we don't have so much money, how can we do it? I think it's the right decision on the All India part of All India Football Federation that the ambulance has to be there. And if you can't do it, please don't play.
No match will be played.
Don't play. Please don't play.
Not only not only fantastic job there, not only top matches, even second division matches local, I'm talking about the local state matches. All India Football Federation never allows now. If the state will do it, they are taking responsibility. But I know this for sure, Federation will never allow even a state match to be conducted if there is no ambulance, if there is no doctor present at the ground.
Even training sessions, in, for example, we were at, sorry, we are perhaps extending this segment a bit more than we are supposed to, but because the topic is, I guess, vast.
Very important.
We all have different experiences of it. Even in the I-League bubble this year, for example, when training sessions were held on non-match days, even for training, you had to have an ambulance present at the training venue. And, you know, there was this conversation happening between certain club management professionals saying that the cost of this is unaffordable and stuff like that. I mean, if clubs also from their perspective, I can understand that there are many financial challenges that clubs face. But if as a football club, you are not willing to invest 2,500 rupees in having an ambulance at the venue when your boys are training to look after them in case of the worst happening, right? This is a worst case scenario that these boys are going through.
Yeah.
Then I think everything has to be brought into question. It's difficult in a country like India where the gaps and the differences in availability of medical facility, financial resources, etc. are so wide. But despite that, I think it's a very important policy decision that has been taken at the top level. And we have to all find a way to work together to ensure that at the lower levels, grassroots levels, non-elite levels, where there are no cameras present, probably no journalists present, you know, there also the same kind of medical attention and care is available to players on the pitch.
Anyhow, I will tell you, you know, like I should tell you, there were league people present during the practice matches also, and they made it clear there won't be any match. Practice match also, training match also, if there is no ambulance.
Yeah,
but
they're very good. You'd have to say that.
But yeah, very good. And hats off to clubs also. I, at least with Kerala, we played matches with Mumbai, Goa, and this was not a problem. This was always taken care. I think now clubs, as Dada said, in modern football, you know, modern Indian football, I will say, these things have, you know, like federation or the league, I from the ISL people and the clubs, and they work together for this because one life is more important than entire football life. And I think everybody knows that.
That's the right way to say it. Okay, so we've had an engaging discussion on what transpired in India and how the situation is handled in India. It's time now for our second segment because not only did the medics handle it really well, but there are also question marks on the way the broadcasters were broadcasting the images in that game between Denmark and Finland. That is coming in our second segment. Right, so the chat is this, that the entire scene played out for close to 20 minutes between Denmark and Finland, and while, you know, medical attention was being given to Christian Eriksen. Now one must realize this, that there is a local broadcaster in Copenhagen. The director is cutting the shots, right? There are 15, 16 cameras, whatever, depending on how many cameras you put. Director is cutting the shots. And the point is, a lot of people are saying that while you're trying to resuscitate him, do we really need to see this? You've been on air for close to 20 minutes. So the way it works is the feed is beamed to various countries, right? Hamare desh mein bhi beam ho raha hai, to various countries it's beamed. And while the people in those countries have no say on the shots that are being taken or the shots that are being given, they do have a say in saying, cut from the live venue and you can come into our studio, right? And which is what a lot of people are talking about, saying cut to studio. You can hear, you can see Ian Wright there. Robbie Fowler as well is saying that people should have cut to studio earlier. These pictures should not be shown on the field since the Meds came on the pitch. Danish Telly has shown drone shots. It's, I don't know, where do you stand, Annie bhai? Kya hai iska situation? Ya to The only thing is ki 20 minute jo aap lage hue ho, aapne 5 minute mein samajh gaye ho the situation is very serious, right? Those boys have formed a circle around him so as no camera can get in and take a picture of Christian's face or whatever medical treatment that's been given to him. Easier said than done. Come to studio because a lot of variables as well. Get the studio ready. Yeah. Get the guests ready. Absolutely.
And you know, broadcasters have to think long and hard about these kind of decisions, the kind of cutting they are doing, and most importantly, the kind of awareness and sensitivity that people who are in studio, who are anchoring these shows, have. It's very well for Ian Wright in his position, having been a top international and top club player, having been through certain experiences in his life and now a broadcaster himself. It's very easy for him to say, not easy, but it's logical for him to say cut to studio, because in that scenario, like we are having this conversation, Ian Wright would probably be able to give the audience some context, give them some information, as well as keep them connected to what is happening on the pitch and the kind of medical attention that is being received. What happens in many scenarios, especially like you're saying in this kind of tournament, which is broadcast around the world, people, broadcasters don't necessarily want to spend money and invest so much in the people that they are bringing into these studio scenarios, and they are limiting their engagement to those pre and...
How do you know that? How many broadcasters have you spoken to that have told you that, for example,
is happening in many situations in Indian football where commentators are doing commentary from a separate location. They are not even on the ground, right? These kind of cost-cutting measures are across the board in play in football, right? If you look at perhaps broadcast budgets of season one when the Indian Super League started 7 or 8 years ago versus the broadcast budget today, if you don't account for inflation, I think that budget has significantly shrunk. Yeah, mostly this has to do with the fact that more money is being spent on cricket coverage year on year, so therefore there is less money for everything else. But that is then a different topic to get into. My point being that when you are using a world feed like this, and you have perhaps people in studio who are not prepared, who have not been through such kind of scenarios, it is very difficult to come back to studio and have a conversation on the subject, because kal ko matlab koi galat bol de ya kisi ne kuch wo kar diya, to it can create more problems. At least the images that are coming from the pitch, from the field over there, there is an experienced production team that is sending out these images and giving you the option of whether or not you broadcast them. So there is some element of some editorial process and guidelines being followed in that context, right? Now, the BBC and others, perhaps as host broadcasters, they have their own setups. They have people on the ground. So they are in a much better position to take those calls. In the case of India, for example, our broadcasters, I don't think they have their own people on the ground giving them real-time verified information. This is what is happening, this is what is not happening. And therefore, my advice to the studio team is that we do this. Cut in, cut out, go to ad, show some pictures.
That decision is not taken by a reporter on ground. That decision is always taken by the EP.
I agree, but the information channel has to be open, right? Where the reporter on the ground is sharing accurate information in real time with the people in studio. Then, of course, the head person in studio whose job it is to make that decision will take the final call. But if that channel of information or reportage is not present, it makes life very, very difficult. So it's therefore in that scenario, in my limited opinion, it is important to have those live images coming, because it gives us a sense of how the teammates are helping, that the boy is receiving medical aid. You know, that immediately within a flash that the medical team was on the pitch by his side and he was probably receiving the best care possible in the entire world. This is something that I think, okay, you can say for taste, not taste. We've all worked at broadcasters.
Subjective hai, bhai. The way you can do it is that, I'm just saying, I'm not saying sahi galat kuch hai. The other option is you come to studio, right? If you come to studio and you let the pictures play out for the people in studio, right? Not for the broadcast.
Yeah, yeah. You can do a delay.
No, no, you don't put out the pictures only.
Yeah, absolutely.
You come to studio, the guy is watching it on, yeah, on a TV in studio, and then you relay whatever you need to relay to the people, right?
Yeah, yeah.
At the end,
yeah,
of the day. But then, sure, there are a lot of variables. In fact, whenever something like this happens in a live sport event, and I know everyone's first thought goes to the player, family, and so on, and teammates. My thoughts also go out to the broadcasters who are present at that time talking about the game, commentators. Because, you know, at that time, it is so difficult. You can be the most crafted of commentators. You can be the most experienced of commentators. You are not prepared for a situation like this. You are never prepared for a situation like this. You only get prepared for a situation like this by being in such a situation, right? So the guys who were commentating last night, you know, they next time they will be prepared. They will know how to go about it because wo actually, you know, they wo tear wo kya kehte hain doobe.
Yeah, yeah, they were pretty much in the deep end. Yeah,
yeah, and in this day that we are living in, where every word is being scrutinized. Aapne kuch galat bola, it's gone on social media. Aapke upar par hawa chal raha hai, and so on and so forth. So sometimes silence is the best. Is the best solution.
Bhai, I mean. At an individual level, at a personal level, I'm inclined to agree with you. But if you are in that job where you are a studio anchor, you are doing live television, I think there is some onus of responsibility also on you. You are doing a job as a professional. So maybe it's not part of expectation to be in this particular kind of scenario when you are actually covering a football match. But we know that things happen. And of course, everyone will learn from this and be mentally prepared. Also, given that, you know, so many things are happening, vaccination processes are happening, COVID-19 is still very much present. So over the course of this 1 month tournament, as well as the Copa that is going on, there is the possibility that things will not go 100% according to plan at all times. And I think in those scenarios, you know, just like it's the job.
You can never prepare for this, bhai. You can never prepare for this, bhai. I'm telling you, I've been in those situations. You can never prepare for a situation like this in broadcast. You can never prepare for it.
No. I agree.
Jinko actually jin pe beatti hai, they can best tell you because kabhi kabhi kya hota, your chain of thought is gone.
Yeah.
Bolun kaise bolun, and that comes sometimes from fear. Ki main kuch galat na bol dun.
Yeah.
You know, sir, हम सब इंसान हैं भाई. इंसान कभी-कभी कुछ बोलने में आप शब्द कुछ और इस्तेमाल कर लेते हो. You don't mean it.
बिल्कुल जाहिर बात है. And like जैसे हमारे पास एक पूरा दिन almost we've had to kind of before we are coming on air and doing our live bit. Yeah. These guys don't have that time.
No, you have that 5 minute
window. Gather your thoughts to get your composure. And of course, we now also have the information that the guy that Ericsson is doing well. That he has been brought back from the brink. And that he's recovering, right? How much he, whatever, those details will come with time. Yeah. But at that point, the guys doing the live studio stuff, they don't have that information. So I completely agree with you that it's a tough situation, but it's a tough job. That's why people like us, for example, don't become anchors, right? I mean, the it's a specialized role for people who have training, who have experience and who have the ability and the kind of intrinsic, the speed of thought to be able to adapt to the situation and remember the audience and give them information that is verified, that is, you know, balanced and responsible. In that
fair,
sense.
Fair. I'm quickly going to end it. Jaideep sir, where do you stand on this on this debate? So it was a 20-minute window, sir. Was being given medical aid at the time.
Hmm.
Would you have wanted to cut away, not show the pictures at all? Because see, at the end of the day, a broadcaster's job is all to paint the story in front of you.
I think, I'm not privy to the rules because I don't know much about television, what are the rules in television and all. But what I thought what you said was right, actually, that they could have cut it off because his wife coming with his tears in her eyes and all. I didn't like looking at it, frankly speaking, if you ask me. They could have cut it off, come back to the studio and keep on giving updates.
Sir, the thing is, you don't know what pictures are coming. You're at the behest of someone who's cutting pictures in Denmark. So you don't know that they have a camera on the wife. That's my point. It's Harry Potter in front of you.
And that the guy who is directing or producing that world feed is cutting to that camera. You know?
Exactly.
You I think no it's their decision, Arjun. I think their decision, sometimes you don't know how serious injury is. Also.
Yeah.
You know, it's that window of 3-4 minutes where you will come to know, and where cameramen, sports cameramen are very smart nowadays, and then directors also. You know, one of them will obviously always focus, and the directors, they have to cut the feed at so they showed it, you know, like going down, clear going down. Once they will get to know that it's a bit serious, then they should cut off to the studio and then give updates. Updates are very important,
yeah.
You know, like, because everybody is waiting and praying, and then talk about maybe medics and others. Or if it's a good news,
yeah.
Okay, finally the good news.
At that time, best is to talk about medics.
Because a lot of viewers are watching. You know, like, people may not like it, or people might feel more emotional, or something happened. Something might happen to someone because of this thing. You know, like, you never know. So it is better. It's very sensitive part. I think the best thing is not to show after 2-3 minutes. Let's go to the studio and talk about it.
Okay, fine, gentlemen. Thank you so much. I think we've come to the end of our show. Once again, lots of love to Christian Eriksen, his entire family, the entire team, and especially to the medics, man, who worked like that and brought him back. So great. Jaideep, sir, Ishwak, Sidhan, thank you once again for your time, and thank you for taking this back.
Thank you, sir.
In what has been a dark patch in Indian football. And it's important that people who follow the game in our country know about what has happened in November 2004. Thank you so much for watching. Just a reminder, we're on Instagram, we're on YouTube, we're on Twitter. Give us a follow, subscribe wherever you want to get your information on our shows.
We now have a ticker that gives the handles as well.
I'm not used to it, sir. Sorry.
Yes, sir.
Kya baat hai, kya baat
hai. Handles, ye hai, wo hai, wo hai, sabko follow karo. आपकी मर्जी है, फॉलो करना है करो, नहीं तो मत करो, कोई प्रॉब्लम।
ये आपने मेरी मुंह की बात छीन ली। हम कौन सा हाथ पकड़ रहे हैं, हम कौन सा कह रहे हैं रस्सी लगा के जी कर लो, हम तो कह रहे हैं करना चाहते हो कर दो। पर थ्रू आउट द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ दिस टूर्नामेंट 1 बजे दोपहर को हम लोग यूरो की बातें करेंगे। अब ये मत समझना कि हम अफगानिस्तान के साथ मैच है तो हम इंडियन फुटबॉल भूल गए जनाब। खर्चा पानी तो वही चलता है। So 15 तारीख को इंडिया वर्सेस अफगानिस्तान है, which means we'll be doing a preview on the 14th and on 15th night we'll be doing a look back like what we did for Bangladesh. Okay. And timings, which is why I said we'll be putting out on Twitter, Instagram and YouTube. हाँ जी इश्वाक, आप कुछ कह रहे थे?
मैं बोल रहा था, why don't you ask those guys who are, you know, like constantly watch us, they tell us what time to come, what is the best time, post match or before, or somebody, you know, like they have questions for the what kind of team should play, you know like let's ask them, make it little different.
Sir, maybe they want to hamare sar pe goli chala rahe ho kyunki hum sawal nahi karte hain. So ye main aur Siddhant ignore kar dete hain, ye rakhe to har waqt bolte rehte hain, ye to kehte hain ki aap hamare sawal kyun nahi lete.
Le lo yaar, hame kya, yahi to is show ki yahi achhi baat hai na,
nahi
hum log selective nahi, jo अच्छा लगता है, जो टीवी पे अच्छा लगेगा वही नहीं दिखाएंगे हम लोग, गंदा पार्ट भी दिखाएंगे।
बिल्कुल सही बात है, एंड दिस इज द टाइम एट व्हिच द डायरेक्टर शुड कट अस ऑफ बिकॉज़ इट्स
गेटिंग, हमारी पोल खुल रही है। जयदीप सर, ऋषवाक, सिद्धांत, वंस अगेन थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर टाइम। वी विल सी यू टुमारो, सेम टाइम सेम प्लेस, 1 पीएम ऑन YouTube। गुड बाय,
थैंक यू,
बाय बाय, बाय बाय,
बाय बाय।
Are we off?
Good touch. Christian Eriksen gets us soon.